How's it going, Savage Life family? Today we're going to be talking about the core differences between Ethereum Classic and Ethereum for those of you who don't know the difference and don't really know what you are invested in. This is going to help break all that information down. So, if you guys didn't know, the Ethereum Classic is the original Ethereum blockchain. The initial design and functionality of these two networks are essentially the same. The hard fork ended up happening in 2016, which split the blockchain into two, Ethereum Classic being one and Ethereum ETH being the other, dividing the community at the time. Now, for you to understand why the community was divided, we have to go back in time, and it all started after the creation of the DAO known as Distributed Autonomous Organization, which pretty much was a venture capital firm that would allow the investors to make all the decisions through smart contracts, and there would be no leaders and no authorities how you want a blockchain to be done. Now, there were several security flaws with the DAO code, which were repeatedly pointed out in May and June of 2016. And the problem lied with re-entrancy. Re-entrancy drains an account through multiple expenditures for the same transaction. So it's not like Ethereum Classic was hacked in the sense of them going into multiple people's account and draining money. It simply served its purpose being immutable, and the fault lied in the error with the DAO. Now, the hacker or hackers stole 11.5 million worth of Ether, worth approximately $50 million at the time. Now, they came up with two solutions or two approaches how to handle this situation. And the first approach was the Ethereum community could either create a fork to reverse the illegitimate transactions or do nothing. Now, the side that decided to do nothing is the original Ethereum blockchain known as Ethereum Classic. And the main argument for doing nothing is that the blockchain was meant to be immutable and free from manipulation by any individual or group. Meaning once Ether was created and the code was done and perfected, there was no going back and making changes, because doing so would remove the purpose of Ethereum being an unchanging smart contract platform with nobody truly in control. Now, ETH or Ethereum, on the other hand, said, forget all that. We aren't going to let them get away with this attack, even if it means changing our very nature. So by stepping in to fix this problem, it completely undermined that objective. If contracts held to be unalterable, meaning unable to be changed, of course, can effectively be overturned by a collective decision to run new software, what guarantee do financial institutions have that their transactions and funds are secure? So now you could clearly see where the divide lies, with ETH taking a majority of the development team with them and moving on to their own course. The team was able to recover nearly $42 million after the fork, restoring the money to the investors of the DAO, but doing so removed the code is law aspect. Now, Ethereum Classic decided to follow in the footsteps of Bitcoin and hard capped the total supply at roughly 210 million coins. This introduces the scarcity element in the network. Ethereum, on the other hand, generates new Ether at consistent rates with no hard cap on the amount of Ether that can be mined. And looking around, you can clearly see where the problem with that resides. Now, on top of that, the developer community is free to change it whenever they see fit. Now, ETH is transitioning their consensus mechanism from proof of work to proof of stake, which means ETH will be a faster, more efficient, and significantly more scalable, meaning more space on the blockchain. But this comes with a cost, and that cost is security, which ultimately will be a system that will be suitable to service consumers and businesses who will need to process high volume, low value transactions. Ethereum Classic, on the other hand, will hold on to the proof of work consensus, following Bitcoin's footsteps, choosing security over speed. In the case of Ethereum Classic, it will be suitable for processing low volume, high value transactions. So you can see how both pretty much go hand in hand with each other. But since the fork, Ethereum has been shown a lot more love than Ethereum Classic. Now, last thing I wanted to mention, some still fear a 51 attack is pending for Ethereum Classic, as it's happened in the past. But to be fair, a 51% attack gets harder and harder as value rises, and the rise in price actually erases the vulnerability, as the cost to launch such an attack would be astronomically high. Market value was underneath 500 million when those attacks happened. So imagine now, and that's not to say ever since the Thanos upgrade that happened in November, drastically increasing the network health and security, with another even stronger upgrade coming next month for the blockchain as well, which is called the Magneto upgrade. Now, ever since 2016, people have been saying Ethereum Classic will die in days. Ethereum Classic is a dead project. Ethereum Classic will die because of 51% attacks. But as you can see, Ethereum Classic is still here and only getting stronger, with more upgrades coming along the way, performing a lot better than a majority of these altcoins. So is Ethereum Classic here to stay? Most definitely. Is Ethereum Classic a great long-term investment? It depends what you think the future looks like. If you're a Bitcoin maximist and believe all altcoins are going to fail besides Bitcoin, then Ethereum Classic is not the investment for you. But at the same time, if you believe there will be blockchain layers with a handful of coins implementing the proof of work consensus, being Bitcoin and Ethereum Classic on top, and base layer stacked on top of those proof of work consensus layer coins, like ETH 2.0 or Cardano, being used for their high volume and low value transactions, then Ethereum Classic definitely is the investment for you. So all in all, both of these are great investments as I see it, and both will give you a return on your investment over time. Now, there you have it. Just want to make this quick, easy, and simple. If you guys enjoyed this update, be sure to smash that like as it helps with the YouTube algorithm, and subscribe. As well, if you haven't yet, join the Discord channel with the link in the description to have some fun, drop some links, and ask me any questions if you have so. I'll see you guys on the next update. Later.